Hello, it's Jang here from JANGBRiCKS.com with a look at the LEGO City set called Arctic Base Camp. It comes with 735 pieces, and this is a serious playset. Here's sort of the default look for the base itself, the main structure. This is built in two major parts, which you then connect together at the end. So it's basically this wing over here and then this wing. They get separately put together. It got a little bit of a passenger plane, large passenger plane style of construction here, just with the parts that are used for the roof and also for the ports on the side, the windows. I think it looks pretty good. I think the decision to go with the arch shape here was a really good one. You've got a conveyor belt here, which you can actually cause to move. You can actually turn this knob over here and be able to pull things up, and the idea there is that you'd be bringing back these big old chunks of ice which may have minerals inside, kind of a mining and exploration sort of thing. Put one of those on there and then you can actually take it all the way up to the top, and then your minifigs can do other things with it up there. They've got a chainsaw right here which they can use to cut it open to get at some of the minerals inside, and they've also got a circular saw over here. But things get more interesting with this entire structure when you open it up. So all this opens up. Let me leave this out for now. All this opens up. This comes down like a ramp, and then back here, this also comes down to give you more access. And if you want to see in there even better, open up the roof here, open up the roof here. In this section, you get a little microscope stand, I believe is what that is, scanning microscope, digital or something, that's going to be bringing in images for analysis so you can start to figure out what the exact contents are of these crystals and these minerals that you're finding. You've also got a radar display here that's going to be showing you what's going on in the air. You can see some of the weather in your area to some degree if you've got precipitation coming in. And it's also showing the helicopter that's included with the set, so you can see exactly when that is coming in. Over on the other side, meanwhile, this is kind of the garage area, and this is where you would store your snow machine. So you see that fits in there just nicely. It still has a little bit of room around the side, so you can kind of pose minifigs in there around it, kind of getting it prepared. Meanwhile, from the other side, this is a little break room area just for hanging out, kind of chilling. And the most interesting thing here to me is that they have what appears to be an old CRT television, the big thick ones with the tube inside. This is a relatively small one. It would be like a, I don't know, like a 13-inch TV, 14-inch maybe, something like that. But it's quite different to see LEGO actually including something so old looking, and it actually even has an antenna on the top. Pretty cool for a modern set. And then up here on the roof, of course, you've got some communications equipment. So you've got a tall antenna, you've got this satellite dish, and then it also has a couple of solar panels there. Those are stickers on top of these pieces. Also, they have the logo for the expedition on a flag there, and that's it. Now we move on to some of the smaller components. This is the largest of the smaller things, and it's my favorite thing in this entire set because I love tracked vehicles, and this one here is a large snowcat style of vehicle, but really ends up looking like a heavy, medium to heavy commercial truck cab right here with tank treads on it. And I think that is really cool. And it's got a crane on the back. I appreciate that. Although the crane is really only set up with this drilling head attachment. You can turn this around to kind of pretend that you're doing some actual drilling work. This thing has enough articulation to easily get down to the ground. And if somehow you had this up on a platform, you could even make this go below, so it would really look like it's going down into the ground. And this is able to turn around. It's actually ratcheted. I've got just a little bit of a panel right there. It's a little bit generic looking, doesn't have any control levers or anything. I would not mind seeing that being used, that exact same look with some other sets and against some different colors. The cab is pretty clean and smooth and modern, pretty much your standard for kind of city fare, right? Take that off, and that's basically all that you're going to do is just get access in there. It has the steering wheel in the center of the whole thing. I appreciate these lights up here on the top. on this rack, and then it's got a whole row of lights here, and then just these beveled lights along the side. Very important to have lots of light, especially because there will be a lot of situations in which they'll be working on or across very short days where you just don't get a whole lot of sunlight. I think this is just a great looking thing. I think the one thing that's missing is a real crane style of attachment, something to really pick up these things. The idea is that, you know, you're gonna drill and then you're gonna get some large cubes like this, or, you know, cores of some sort out of the surface beneath you, but it would be nice if this could actually pick these up. Now, one sneaky little thing here that's really interesting to me is that they make this just very easy to roll around, which is not normal for things with tracks on them. Usually, if you go with rubber tracks, you're gonna have to push down hard and really put some effort into making them turn. With these plastic ones, oftentimes they'll try to lock up a little bit if you get them just wrong, but what they did here was really, really smart. Not the most realistic thing, but underneath, most of the weight is supported by a wheel and tire. Kind of makes for a cool look because it looks like the thing leans back under acceleration, and when you brake, it kind of, you know, pushes forward. But the most important thing there is that it just makes it easier to roll this around on different kinds of surfaces. This helicopter is pretty small, but more so, it's pretty plain. To me, it looks very kind of, I don't know, kind of blocky and maybe even unfinished from the side compared to the norm. I'm fine with the low profile landing skids. Kind of makes for an interesting different look. Might have looked better standing up, but the sides just to me look kind of lacking. The thing about this that's good is that it is intended to actually haul stuff. So this is like a small heli crane, you know, it's a lifter. So this has the winch on the back. You can access it from both sides. And this is the thing that you're going to be using to haul out your loads of ice and raw material. Easiest way to do that is to hook up one of these little adapters, standard old fare, makes it very easy. Just hook the hook underneath there and take the thing away, and you can take it to your base. However, what they really suggest here is that you use this whole contraption, and I hate these contraptions because they're just kind of a pain the way that they're done. It's so easy for the netting to come off this little piece. You're supposed to hook the corners around, and then you can have some, you know, your cargo in here inside of the net. Hook the corner there, hook the corner there. But it's so easy for this to fall out. It looks really good when you do it perfectly, but I think that kids might get a little bit frustrated trying to set that up every single time, because those corners can easily pop off, and when you're not using it every single time, it's just gonna fall apart. So personally, I prefer to just take this thing off and just hook it up directly. Now, this snow machine or snowmobile, also basic, not a whole lot of parts used with it, but I think this is really cool. This is really good looking. Keeps it down close to the ground, has a nice wide stance to it, nice amount of smoothness, kind of has a kind of a sleek feel to it, light there, proper handlebars. It doesn't have actual treads, but I think for how few pieces they actually contributed here and how few pieces you actually pay for, I think that, you know, for this particular assembly, I think that you get something that looks really cool. This is very interesting. Dog sled with a new type of dog. Always exciting to get a new type of animal from Lego, especially in minifig scale or anything that can be used with minifigs. These are little huskies, and you get a whole team of them. They're all connected together, and this thing has a ball joint on the back, so they're able to kind of turn, pull it around like that. Makes for a pretty good look. They're all harnessed in. Interesting little thing. It's a new mold. See the big fluffy tails on the back? This has actually, looks like radar on it, interestingly, on the back. And it has a little dispatch microphone handset thing there, so that makes sense. This is just intended to be a little crate for cargo, so you can take that off. Here it's got some fish in it. Presumably you went out to a fishing hole and did some fishing with this whole little reel that you've got here, or a reel and rod. And yeah, this doesn't particularly impress me that much. It kind of looks large and bulky, and I think it would have been nicer if it was narrower and longer or something, but I think it's good to get something different like this. Something animal powered here, something unusual for Lego, and something very appropriate for the region where all this would be taking place. This is the new polar bear from Lego in minifig scale, and I like it. I think it looks pretty cool. The trick here is that it is not a new mold. It's a mold that hasn't been given to us in this color before, but let's just quickly compare this to the old Lego polar bear there and the current Lego brown bear. You see, the white one is the new one, the polar bear, the new polar bear, is actually the same mold as this. They just did it in all white this time. I think it looks pretty good. It worked out pretty well, and you also are able to make it stand up on its hind feet if you want to do that. So that's pretty cool, and you can move the head up and down. And just like the old one, you are able to put a fish in its mouth. 7 minifigs included here. Left to right, you've got the pilot for the helicopter. This is the chief scientist or chief researcher who's going to spend most of his time back at the base. And then everybody else is whatever you want them to be. You get one female character here and the rest are all male. Notice that the pants, the legs and hips on all these last 4 are exactly the same, but the torsos are not, because the female one gets a slightly different torso print. And there's what they look like from the back. Interesting that this one here has the camera, which actually has a huge old tape in it, so that's a very old print. Also interesting here is the set of snowshoes. They're nice and short. They're done in reddish brown. And the way these are set up, the backs, the heel portions here, are each a half of a peg. As you see back here at the base, you've got a pair of them in a single hole. Very cool. Something that I did not notice before actually getting these things in my hands. Well, what can I even really say to sum this up? I think if you like the theme, this is a great set to get, because obviously it has so many things devoted to that theme. If you don't like the theme, maybe you'll like one thing in here, maybe a couple of things, but it probably won't be worth making a purchase. I myself just love the drilling truck, and I like the Huskies too. I think that if it wasn't 90 to 100 degrees right now during the day here in California at the time of the release of this set, I would be able to kind of get into the whole theme a little bit more. You know, I'd be able to a little bit better identify with these little folks here doing some stuff in cold weather. But as it is right now, it's just so hot that it's difficult for me to really put myself into a sympathetic mindset, I would say, to really be able to connect with all this stuff that's going on here. I do, though, appreciate the builds, how many things are included here, how many things can be done, and I think that this is a good value of a set for somebody who wants it. It's just definitely not for everybody. What do you think, though? What do you think about the individual components? What do you think about the total mass of things that are included with this set for its price? Does it seem like a good value? Does it seem like they've put in the correct individual elements? Or would you have taken some of the cost of maybe, let's say, the helicopter or some of the minifigures or the sled or something, and use that to put in some other kind of vehicle or some other kind of structure instead? I do look forward to seeing what other folks think, but for now, I'm going to move this to the side, build some more stuff, and bring you some more videos. Thank you for watching this one. Be sure to hit thumbs down if you disliked the video, or thumbs up if you liked it, and I'll talk to you again soon.